following instructional video demonstrates how to create and print an airbill for a domestic carrier letter using FedEx Express Saver as a shipping service within the eShip Global system. In addition to printing airbill labels, they can be sent via email to another party, previewed in HTML, and printed from the email recipient's location. The controls at the bottom of the screen allow pausing, fast forwarding, rewinding, and replaying of this video. eShip Global provides one easy-to-use interface to create shipping labels for FedEx, UPS, DHL, and the United States Postal Service. This third-party service allows you to review shipping costs at Yale contracted rates and choose the most effective shipping solution. Additionally, eShip Global ensures the proper purchasing protocol is followed by using online validation of the Yale VIP or Pateo number and initiator on every transaction. Each transaction is tied back to Yale financial statements through the package order number, VIP or Pateo, and initiator. Open a web browser and go to www.yale.edu/portal. The Yale University portal page will appear. After the web page opens, click Login to the portal. The Yale Central Authentication Service page will appear. Enter your Yale NetID in the NetID box. Enter your Yale NetID password in the password box. Then click the Logon button. Click on the Express Shipping eShip Global link from within the Yale Services section. The eShip Global main navigation window will appear. To begin creating a package label, click on the word Ship from the eShip Global main navigation window. Since this is not a shipment containing research materials or dry ice, click on the radio button next to the word No. In this example, we will be shipping a domestic carrier letter. Click on the button next to the word Domestic. Click on the drop-down arrow in the Ship From field to select a sender from your saved sender addresses. The next step is to enter or select your package recipient address information. If you have already stored the recipient's information in your address book, you can choose a recipient from the address book by clicking on the Load from Address Book button. For this example, we are assuming this is a new recipient who has not been added to your existing address book. To include this new recipient address in your saved address book, click in the box next to Add to Address Book, or leave the box blank if the address will not be needed for future deliveries. In this example, we will create a shipping label for an individual located at a company's address, and will enter the company name in the company or contact name box, which is a required field. When a package is delivered to a company, the recipient's name should be listed in the alternate contact name box. Complete the recipient address information by utilizing the Address 1 and Address 2 boxes provided. Enter the recipient's city or town in the city box. Click on the drop-down arrow next to the state field. Select the appropriate state. Enter the zip code associated with the recipient's address. Enter a contact number for the recipient using the example format provided. If you would like to notify the recipient about the package delivery status, enter the recipient's email address in the email box. Use the package information section to provide details about the package. Carrier letter is the default option for express shipping. In the package information section, click on the arrow next to package type and choose the type of package for the recipient. Shipping reference and content description are optional fields. In the billing references section, enter either the VIP number or Pateo where the shipping cost should be charged. There will be a short pause while the charging numbers are validated. The initiator is the person who requested that the package be shipped. Begin typing in the last name of the initiator, followed by the first name, and then select the individual from the list of available options. Special instructions and email notifications are optional. If you previously entered the recipient's email address and would like to notify the individual about delivery status, please click on Notify Recipient from within the Email Notifications section. If you would like to notify the sender about package delivery status, click on Notify Shipper. Click the Show Quote button to see a list of preferred vendors who are able to deliver to the recipient address you entered. Each service will be associated with Yale's contracted rates. Itemized transaction charges will be displayed for each shipping carrier with their related services. Please review the itemized transaction charges along with the sender and recipient information before making your final selection. Select the carrier service and contracted rate that meets the delivery requirement for your package. If you would like to edit the sender or recipient information or update package details, click Edit Shipment to return to the main shipping form. After you have reviewed your recipient and sender information along with the package details, select a shipping carrier and service, and then simply click the Ship button. There will be a short pause while your request is being processed. To print your shipping label, click the Print Airway Bill button. The eShip Global shipping label will display. Click the Print Airway Bill link from within the Label Preview section. Select a printer from the list of available options. After the selection has been made, click the Print button. When the shipping label is printed, fold the paper in half and insert it into the plastic sleeve of your envelope. The airbill information should be facing through the window so that it can be easily scanned by the carrier. To return to the package summary window, click the Back to Summary link. From within the package summary window, you can cancel a shipment, schedule a FedEx pickup, create a return order, view your shipment history, or email a label to someone else if you would prefer not to print it. Scroll to the top of the package summary window to ship a new package or perform other actions in the system. From this point, you can perform other actions in the system or simply log out. Express shipping training guides are now available online. Go to www.yale.edu/yalebiz.